Microbiology brain teasers.
Let's start with today's chapter. So today's chapter is related to the immunity part, and immunity I will be discussing regarding the complement. So the first question that is normally being asked is, what is a complement? So you have to remember that complements are the proteins that are present in the blood. What are they? They are basically the proteins. Okay? What are complements? Yes, they are the proteins. The next question that comes is regarding the presence of complements in our body. If you remember, the complements, since they are present in the blood, but they are not formed in the blood, they are formed in liver, in spleen, in macrophages, and in intestine. Okay, so you have to remember that the complements are formed in these places. Okay, fine. The next question that is being asked, or you have to remember, is regarding how are they formed? How are they formed? So you have to remember that they are normally present in the blood in inactive form. These inactive forms are made active when they encounter the infection. These inactive forms are normally known as zymogens. What are they known as? Zymogens. Okay, they are known as zymogens. So you can remember like this, that what are they, where are they produced, and how they are made active. Okay, I'm moving on to the next slide. What is the nomenclature? The complements are normally nomenclated by the term C, and they numbers from C1 to C9. Okay, the first point is about the nomenclature. They are named from C1 to C9. Next question is, they have got two fragments, A and B. Normally B is the bigger fragment, and it is the fragment that is used while carrying on the reactions, and A is the one that is not the attached fragment. But there is an exception where A is the attached fragment, and that is with the complement C2. Okay, first is exception is C2. Another exception is regarding C1. C1 is not a single complement. It is a complex of Q, R, and S subunits. Okay, so you have to remember these two points. First is C1, another one is C2. Clear? C1 and C2. Moving further, what are the pathways? There are three pathways which you have to remember about complement. One is classical, another one is alternate, and the third one is binding pathway or lectin pathway. Things which you have to remember is that this classical pathway is antibody dependent, whereas these two are antibody independent. So since they are antibody independent pathways, these two pathways form the part of innate immunity. Okay, whereas classical form the part of acquired immunity. I hope the general introduction is clear with every one of you. You have to remember the stages when we proceed with any of these pathways. There are four stages. First is initiation, initiation state. Second is the formation of C3 convertase enzyme. Third is formation of C5 convertase. And finally, the formation of membrane attack complex. Remember, these three stages are common all the three pathways. The difference lies in the initiation of the reaction. Clear?
I hope you have liked my video. Kindly share, subscribe, and comment on my video.